Hi all, sorry for not conducting this live this week because as I mentioned, we are already into the food distribution drive and that is the main reason why I'll be doing a recording even next weekend, okay, because we have got, some voluntary work to be done for this two weekends, okay, so sorry for that and we'll get it again from me. I think we'll be again doing it on weekend to weekend, right? So let me show you what we had last week. So we had this acting as support, but that was broken. But then see, we are above this, so we are at around 14,550 right now, and we need to take support here and here. These are the true levels from where we have bounced actually last week. Now we have to see whether we are able to recapture this or not. Okay, so that is going to be the main thing. Bank Nifty had broken further and it had bounced sharply as well. So we'll have to see what is to be done here as well on both the indices. Mainly, IT has pushed up strongly, that been into the diamond category and then it started to fall, right? Then we saw FMCG also doing some fall in the last week, and then we had some rise on few stocks. So we'll have to see even that. Okay, Nifty Auto also needs to be done properly. So we had a few trades on MRF and Maruti. Maruti didn't trigger though. MRF gave us good money on the short side, and maybe now the long is about to trigger as well. So we'll have to even see that. Nifty Pharma did fantastic. We had all the targets met on Dr. Reddy, right? So it seems to be a good week so far. Now let's see what we had on stocks. I think Reliance didn't trigger at all, the buy one. Asian Paint did trigger on Friday and it gave us some good money. Nestle didn't trigger. Dr. Reddy triggered and also met the target of 5115, right? MRF buy didn't trigger, but short triggered and it gave us the target. Maruti did trigger, TCS sell triggered and it gave us the target as well on Monday itself, right? So yes, there were few stocks which did good last week as well. So now let's start with this week and see what we get in the market. So if you see right now also, we are around 14,645, so 14,650 you can say. We are at resistance of 20 MA on daily. We need now to close this gap to have an upside movement further, or we might have some fall now again back to this levels, because my main task is that currently with the growing cases in India, there would be some pressure even on the markets, right? This is the base right now, okay, and we might see somewhere some movement on the sideways side, okay, but if you look at this particular part, okay, so this is actually a descending wedge and this can act as a very powerful support. So this can be the area from where we can bounce, and so 14,300 becomes a good base for us right now. So this is going to be a good base, and if we are able to sustain 14,300 for maybe a week or two, then we might see a bounce back in the market and we might have a breakout with a new high. Okay, so let's see what the market does. But currently it shows some weaknesses. Okay, and we need to see whether we are able to take support on the budget day candle. Right, so this is the Nirmala 2.0. So we need to know that, you know, we are able to make this sustain. Okay, so for the bulls, this is going to be an important levels. Let's see on weekly what does it show. Let me remove these lines. So weekly is also like a doji at 20 MA support as well as 60 support. So it makes sense right now to say that yes, we are still in the bullish zone on even the weekly part, and monthly I think it is about 60, so that's nothing to bother here as well. So monthly weekly shows good sign. We need to cross at least 14,900 in this week so that we close the gap on weekly basis. Because you should remember we had a gap down on Monday, so that's a weekly gap as well. Okay, so this needs to be closed, and that's even the daily gap. So we need this to be closed. So above 14,900, we might again see the movement till 1566 or 1575 level. So let us write down on Nifty what we see. So again, I like to push this. So see, every week 14,800 appears either on the support or the resistance side, right? So that is what it is doing, and now we need this to be closed. Okay, so I'm going to remove 15,500 for now, and here we'll have to add one more support, okay, which is 14,000. Actually, it is 14,100, which is acting as a good support, though we have not retested it at all right now. Okay, in last, I think 2 months, we have not seen these levels yet on Nifty. Okay, so again, let us write down this. Daily series of dojis nahi hai, but daily doji at 20 MA resistance hai abhi. Okay. Weekly is above 60 and doji, monthly doji above 60. So, and doji mein nikal deta hu ki ye time doji nahi hai. Okay, so weekly. I'll put it here actually, doji above 60 or at 60 actually. Okay, it's not above, it is just around 60. If you look at weekly, we have a doji here at 20 MA and 60 support. Okay, so we'll write that doji at 60 and MA 20 support. So this is what we have in Nifty. Let's go to Bank Nifty. BNF has actually broken 60 on weekly, and now if we have a gap up tomorrow, which again is a issue, then we might see an island reversal on weekly basis, which might take it back to this level. Okay, so there can be an island reversal if you have a gap up and that gap sustains throughout the week. So that is a condition. Okay, similar thing on here, we are at 40 support, but see again around the gap resistance. Okay, so 32,600 is one resistance that we have, and then we have another resistance which is around 33,000. So there are multiple you can see resistances due to the gaps that have been created in the market. So we need to close this gap first, and then only you can expect it to go above. So 33,100 is going to be the resistance for this week. Now break of this can result into more fall. Okay, then you can expect 29,000 also reaching in Bank Nifty. Then this can be also where we might see 40 on weekly basis with lower band support. Okay, so this can sorry, I had lost the connection, so was mute for some time. Okay, so now again, let's see this. Okay, so we do have some resistance, and monthly is also now shaky, but it is at CIP. So we need to see if the month closes above 32,600. So if we have a monthly close above 32,600, we might still have, you know, 60 and hammer and on monthly. So we need to see what banking does from here. So this is where, you know, we need the close about this, then only it makes sense, otherwise it does not make sense to us. Okay, otherwise then there can be a fall, as we saw 29,000 is then approaching, and then maybe, you know, even 27,400 can come back. Okay, and this is again at price support. If you look at it, right, so check price support along with the candle. Volume is decent, but not more than what we had on the last week. And this Doji had a very low volume. So we have more volume than the Doji earlier. Now we need to see whether it's a shoot back or still, you know, hanging around the same levels. So again, for Bank Nifty, we need to cross above 32,600. Okay, so let's see that now. Can be first bullish range shift as well. Okay. Weekly below 60 and also below 20 EMA. So let's see whether we have a selectors too. Yes. Okay. Okay, monthly sliding below 60 as well. Okay, so now for this we need to see 3500 will be also on the resistance side. Okay, so I'll make this as 32,650 rather. Okay, because that is the gap. Okay, and we'll have to add one more here now. Okay, so these two are the major, because then only we cross about 20 MA and also we fill the gap. Otherwise, there is no upside right now on Bank Nifty as well. And it can be a range bound movement for some time. Right, so that is where we need to be seeing this week. So let's see what the stocks also shows to us. Right now, let's move to the other indices. Let's see Nifty IT. So yes, IT had a fall from the diamond index. There is no more in diamond index now. It is at 20 MA support. A black candle, so it's almost, if you look at it, dark cloud cover. Okay, but at 60 support, so that is critical. And still a doji around, okay, on monthly. So monthly still is showing some strength and still above 80. Okay. So still there is not a divergence here, but we need to be careful. There can be a 4 to 5 bar there is divergence here. Okay, so IT bubble might have a blast. So let's see what it does. So again, it's now no more diamond. Okay, so it's going to go. Okay, so now again, daily is a doji. If you look at it at 20 MA support. And below 60, so it has broken 60, right? Now weekly again, weekly at 60 support and monthly bullish candle above shooting star high. Okay, so now again it has turned to monthly doji. Okay, and now this does not hold good, so we'll remove this. There was some correction in IT stocks. Now let's see infra. So what is infra done? Infra has also done the same thing. Now that also has a gap. So that needs to be filled first. It's a hammer on 60. So this makes sense. 60 and price support. And even monthly is looking good. I think we might have some month of sideways after what we did saw in the market. Okay. And then there can be again, you know, a rally on the upside. So there can be some sideways movement expected in infra as well. Okay, it might come again till here, but see, there is a gap here. So it needs to fill the gap at around 4150. Then only, you know, you might see some upward movement again till 4220. Let's see that. Okay. Now let's go to the next sector, FMCG. So FMCG on daily is at 60 resistance and gap resistance. Look at this. It is at gap resistance. And daily is at 60 resistance. Weekly क्या दिखा रहा है? Weekly is at 60 support. Weekly is first 60 support again after this fall. So it shows to be, you know, doji at 60 with bearish divergence setup. Okay, and it also an M setup if you go to see. Okay, so it does has an M setup actually. Perfect textbook M setup here. So this is the level till which the stocks can come down to. And if this is broken, then this is the level. Right, from upper band to lower band is always the target. So you have to see even the FMCG stocks for the same. And monthly also shows bearish divergence actually. So you'll have to see where it confirms on this month. It's also no more a diamond index now. Right, so there is an M setup on weekly which we need to now see. Okay, let's see the other indices. So pharma is looking good, but we also now need to see this 70. So there is no bearish divergence now. It looks good. Pharma is looking good, and there is a bounce even here. It's about 60, and here also we need the month to close 71 and 68. So let's see whether it comes up again to this level where here it had touched. Okay, so let's see. So pharma is still looking okay to us. Okay, so pharma is looking good. All time frame above 60. Golden index for sure. It did record about 1208, and so that is already done. Okay, so it's already a breakout now. Price resistance at 13200. So we now need to go above that because we are just around that. See, 13200. Okay, so we are just around the price resistance. Now a breakout on that makes it do a band walk on daily, and we can touch this high which it had touched. The all-time high for this index is again at 14,000, so that can now be retested, because if you look at this, this is around 14,000. So this now needs to be retesting. So this, if it comes to the upper band, this index also makes a new high. Okay, so this is possible. So let's look at pharma stocks for more action. Okay. So pharma sector is looking good, and it has to be right, pandemic. So this sector should do good. Okay, so now let's see the stocks. Okay, I want to see Nifty Metals, but I know many people are tracking that. So I'll just show you Nifty Metals. The auto bhi baki hai. Let's see Nifty Metals first. So Nifty Metals on daily has got dojis and it is still at gap resistance, but above 60. Okay, it shows good bounce and band walk. And this is a good breakout. So now this level becomes a good support level for us. Okay, and if you have to see it, it's also 50%, okay, of this candle. Okay, so it looks good. Let's see what Nifty Metal does. So this can be a retesting on the breakout, and then it can go to the good level. So that's why I think we are already in buying on NMDC on equity, as well as Tata Steel Bhushan. And we might see some movement over there as well, right? That looks good. Okay, and now let's go to Nifty Auto. So auto is forming a hammer on monthly at support. See, look at this. Okay, it's a CIP as well. Okay, and it is at 60 support. So can you look at the first 60 support? Let's see, month is yet to be over, so we should not anticipate anything, but let's wait. Okay, and if you look at here, we need to cross again 9099, or maybe, you know, 10,000, so that we go cross the gap again. So 10,000 ke upar mein close, we should be good with auto sector to retest 11,000. Okay, daily is at 40 support. See, first bullish ring shift, and we did have some profit booking on Friday. See, Friday we were expecting some fall towards the end of the market, because I don't think so in this situation anyone would be, you know, willing to take positions home. So that is what has happened on Friday, and that is the reason why there was a good green day, halted at a good resistance of 20 MA and brought down. Okay, look at this. This has been resisting, this has been resisting, again resisting. So if any new attempt is made, there can be a breakout till 10,300 on auto stocks. So let's see now the stocks as well. So let's write down first on auto. Okay, so daily 40 support, and that has been the trick so far. Series of dojis at 20 MA resistance, this remains same. Weekly doji at price and 20 MA support, but below 60, I think that also remains same. No, it is now below 20 MA, so this has been broken. but there is a doji at price support and below 60. Okay, so we need to say this. Below 60 MA and 20 MA. Okay. This is still fine. Monthly is above 60. Okay, so that is still okay. Chance of first bullish range here. That holds good. Okay, so now let's start with the stocks. Let's see, ACC weekly at 60 support. There is also 58 and 60 diameter. It's spinning top at all time high, but no volume. But for 60 support as well, no trade here. Okay, if we there close the gap, there can be a trade till at least 1950. But now I would not be risking this. Grassen looks good, daily at 40 support and the gap is quite far. There is a weekly PRD as well. Monthly is at, so let's see now, where do we buy this? Grassen looks good. Okay, let me just start fresh here. It's 1:2 risk reward. 30 rupees is going to be the risk and 60 rupees is the reward. So the asset looks good. And this is looking good. Sri Cement hammer at 60. Weekly, monthly. So this is also looking good. So cements are looking. So cement looks good so far. Okay, let's even look at no, this is not good. See, we like Grassen because there is no gap. The gap is still higher. So there is a scope for a trade over here. We are at gap. So forget this. Forget this. Forget no. I'm not liking it. Similar to ACC actually. Okay, so look at week. Now let's go to Asian Paint. Asian Paint had got typically bearish divergence setup. So 65 and closing is 2642. This is 2664 and we have 63. So 65, 63. So this looks little bit bad to me. Okay, this is outside inside as well. But if you look at this candle and this candle, we don't have anything. But with this white and this, we do have. So again, I would suggest two things here. So let's see, weekly carrier. Weekly mein kuch garbad nahi hai. Monthly is also at, okay, resistance of upper band. So if it has to go till this, okay. Should paint also, you can still have it. Target remains the same. So this remains a new trade for Asian Paint. Okay, we can still continue with the same. I think when we traded in stock ideas, we booked profits at 2680. Okay, from 268, I think 2680 or 2682, so around 20 rupees or 18 rupees was booked. Okay, so now you can have this again, a new trade at 2700 for the same target and with a stop loss at 2660. Let's see what it does. So Reliance now, let's see. Doesn't seem to be any trade here in Reliance actually. It is at 60 around support on monthly, and there can be see, it also has got a gap, and there is multiple inside bar, so this can be on either side, but currently it is below 40 and resisting 40. That's why there can be a deep fall also in Reliance till 1850 levels. Okay, but I would stay away from it. Okay, because there can be a chance of this going out any side. So if it crosses this, immediately the resistance is here, but then downfall has no resistance and it can come down till here. So let us have this at least. Currently, we bounce also from a gap support. So, avoid Reliance. Jonado. Let's go to FMCG. Let's go to Hind Unilever. Isme bhi see this multiple inside bars within this one thing. See, ek hi range mein hai. Thank you. it's at 38% retracement. So 30 rupees versus almost 50 rupees. And we will also have one more trade on lever, which is a short trade. Sir, actually I'm connected on my phone and it's ringing. So this is going to be the trade even on short side. Four trades so far we have got. Now let's go to the other thing, Nestle. We had last week also, and it's now coming towards the entry level. We had an entry above this, still 800 points. It's monthly at 60. Daily it has bounced already, so now we have to wait for a new entry. So Nestle jaane do. Okay, usme bhi chhota sa hi gap hai, zyada gap nahi hai, but I would avoid it. Okay, so let's see. Dabur. So Doji. It's doing good actually. Buy above Doji's high with Doji's low as stop loss, and it is looking good. It is a diamond stock actually, all time high. But Doji at all time high can be a both sided trade. The short can be also till here, till maybe this candle. Dabur is looking okay to me. Nestle is okay. Unilever on both sides possibly. But we do had an M setup on weekly on FMCG overall. Right. So we are now not siding much there. Okay. Let's see. This also has got immediate resistance below 60. This is at 40, but see, there is a gap resistance. So not that good. Okay, jaane do isko. Let's go to banking sector. HDFC Bank is at see resistance here. So if the gap is not been closed yet, it's a doji at 40. So again, buy only about the candles high. Looks interesting. HDFC Bank looks good actually. It's 40 support on daily and 60 on monthly. So let's see if it bounces and it gives us an entry here. You can expect till this level. 1490 is this. Not bad, I think. We should bet something out here. Let's look at Axis Bank. It's also at 40 support and similar setup. IndusInd, multiple dojis with, look at this, okay, it's again multiple inside bars, look at this. This is looking good. This is really good. Okay, if it bounces, which side it will, so we'll mention this, or I will have a watch on this closely. Okay, any breakout should be a good breakout. So IndusInd looks good. Let's see Kotak. Okay, this is also at 40, and see every bank is at 40 support now. We need to see lower band on weekly and upper band 40 and around 60 on monthly as well, and price support. So this is the price support actually. So we now need to see what it does here. Let's see SBIN. It is also at 40 and just need to close the gap. Oh, it's a huge gap here actually on weekly. Okay, let's see Bajaj. Everything is broken right now on this side, so we'll have to wait. So HDFC is a good trade so far, I've found. ICSA is good if you buy above 580. Yeah, looks good. By 80 to 600 looks to be a good target, and stop loss should be around 566. So again, it's not a bigger target, but if you look at it, is 1:1. So I would avoid it. Right now, let's go to Maruti and the auto part. Again, series around the doji. Weekly doji. at 40. Keep this as is. I'm not going to move this. Let's see where it can be. Let me now go into something else. Actually, I'm liking it, so I want to go much more into detail about it. So Maruti still looks good. Okay. Let's see, Hamara Bajaj. Target is actually 3765, but I'm keeping it 3760 now. See, MRF also has got multiple Harami, but this is the bearish Harami setup. But still, I would be looking it for a long because this is at 40. So again, that remains same. So you can buy it now. 80 to 600. Okay. Straight away resistance. छोड़ दो. There is a bullish divergence and there is a confirmation as well, but छोड़ दो. Okay, it's at gap resistance. Okay, let's go to BRR now. Daily took 60 support, 2 dojis, still a buy above 4950. Can still expect the same. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 trades so far. Let's see the other stocks. Cipla looks good. There is divergence though, 78 and 77. Weekly looks good. Monthly is more beautiful. So we need to see whether it breaks down or it continues with the upside. Oro, I have already recommended anyone to buy it in cash. It's a good cup breakout. Look at this. Okay, it's a good multi-year breakout above 60. Look at this, 2016, and now see. Okay, it also took 60 support. So this is looking good. I think we had a buy at 900 in cash equity, and the target is around 1100. So if anyone wants to buy it in equity, can buy it. This is also looking good, but see, same thing, daily there is divergence, 4 bar 5 bar, sorry, in this case also. Okay, now let's see. DVs may be same, 68 or 67, this may be here, but it's also a doji above this. So DVs का वी हैड गिवन अ बाय 3600, ओके, 3600 टू 3900 वाज अ टारगेट व्हिच वाज अचीव्ड, ओके, सो इफ यू रिकॉलेक्ट 2 weeks बैक, इवन दैट वाज इन इक्विटी, इफ एनीबॉडी वांटेड कैन कुड हैव बॉट इट, नाउ सी इट इज एक्जेक्टली अराउंड 60 एंड अ डोजी एट 60 रेजिस्टेंस एंड प्राइस रेजिस्टेंस, वी विल हैव टू सी व्हाट इट डज हियर, इज दिस अ न्यू ब्रेकआउट और डज इट फॉल फ्रॉम हियर, ओके, वी विल हैव टू सी दैट नाउ. And now let's go to TCS and the remaining sector, which is IT. So exactly see at gap resistance, and it has had a fall on Friday from there. 60 support, so not much. And there is a bearish divergence at a 3 bar, and that is below this it confirms. So I would wait for a week to see what it is doing, because it seems to be a broken index, broken stock now. It's a perfectly in M setup as well. So everything has to be on the short side for this, but there is a bounce from 20 MA. If this fails, it comes down till this level. So then it's going to be a good shot. Infield daily is at 40 and it has bounced from 40, 60, 60. So it's actually strategy 2A, 40, 60, 60. But again, there is straight away the gap here. So I would avoid it right now. Infosys TCS does not give us any break. Okay, let's see. Wipro had a good breakout. Let's still avoid. Look at the RSI and look at the divergence here. Okay, let's see what does. Doesn't seem to be good. Okay, I think looks okay. It can come to here again. 60. This can be a trade, but it's going to be very less, 40 rupees, and this is again maybe, you know, 20-25 rupees on the downside. So I would avoid it. Let's go to Tata Steel. Metal was looking good, but now again, see, this is also at gap resistance. Doji, so you buy about Doji 917, and it's almost at a new all-time high. It's again a good breakout, so we'll have to wait for this breakout as well. So this breakout has already happened one, and now we'll have to see whether it comes down and takes support somewhere around this level and bounces back, or it goes above this. So yes, if it crosses the all-time high, you again go long and hold it. This is looking okay. JSW Steel looks okay. So this was a cup breakout again. Look at this breakout. And now thing I see, this is now gone, okay? See, look at the volume here and look at the volume on Shooting Star. So now game over for JSW Steel. It's already given the target as well. आ गया टारगेट, और क्या चाहिए? खत्म. ठीक है, ओके. सो आई थिंक वी डू हैव गुड ट्रेड, सो ये मुझे निकालने पड़ेंगे. ओके, सो वी डू हैव अराउंड 9 ट्रेड्स, ऑफ विच सेल इज वन ऑन हिम यूनिलीवर. ओके, रिमेनिंग आर बाय. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस नेक्स्ट वीक. ओके, सो थैंक यू ऑल एंड सॉरी फॉर नॉट कंडक्टिंग दिस लाइव. Okay, we'll see again next weekend. Also would be same, if I'm able to reach home faster, we might do it live, but you know, my view would be I'll still do recording. Okay, so let's keep it that way for next weekend as well. So thank you everyone. Bye.